Yeah. I call corner.
Oh. Yeah, Zach, come here. Come sandwich in the middle with me.
Do I look good?
I think a role I took on as a leader this year on the team was in practice, bringing energy and helping everybody else work hard, being a leader in that role, and just bringing a lot of effort in practice and then transferring that over to the game.
Well, I have been playing all 4 years, and I was looking forward to my senior year and taking a leadership role. And the main thing that I wanted to do as a senior on the football team and as a captain was I wanted to lead by example. So if I felt that we needed to pick something up, then I would take that as a leader and I would start ramping up what I'm doing.
I guess my way of being a leader in this our senior year, just by being a senior, I feel like every one of us is a leader in our own way. And I felt like I had a tight bond with a lot of the juniors. And with that, I felt like I helped make our team more tightly knit.
Any injuries from any of you guys this year?
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. Well, unfortunately, I missed half the season due to me breaking my collarbone.
Did that happen during the game?
It was Greenbrier. I got in, I ran a route, and then I went to turn up field. As soon as I turned up field, I got hit. And then, I don't know, probably by safety or a linebacker.
He caught the ball. He caught the ball, that's what matters.
Glass half full.
That's what matters.
I'd say, whenever I took a leadership role, it was mainly during games. Whenever we kind of got down a little bit, I would kind of, you know, try to rally up all the other players to keep their head ups.
I'd say especially this year at practice, there was a lot more energy and people were coming to practice and ready to practice and not just being there because we had to be there. I feel like everybody enjoyed practice here. I think it's because we ran it a lot differently than we have in the past. So everybody was getting to do something and not, you weren't just standing there during practice. The whole practice you were doing something, even if it was being scout team, the starters, or just being like blockers on the scout. Didn't really matter, everybody was doing something at practice and it was making us get a lot better. And I feel like we had more fun at practice doing that.
Yeah, and with the coaching changes to practice, making it more efficient, I think it got people more excited to come work and get better for the next week. And every week we continually got better and our offensive defenses were clicking. And the thing that made this year so fun, honest, was pregame. Pregame hype is a real thing in this room that we're in. It gets really loud, people get amped up, ready to go kick some tail. And yeah, I think that's one thing I'll never forget about being a Fairview Yellow Jacket is the pregame and then just going down and going to war with my guys.
So Harpeth, I know we beat them, But nobody trash talks a kicker, but they did. I think they're jerks.
I think Camden was a pretty intense game. I mean, it got pretty intense through that game, and
being in such a tightly knit group with other people who I know would have my back on the field, no matter what the situation was, and would fight till the very end, no matter what happens. And it was just a very surreal experience for me, and I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world.
Coach Jackson, I think he's my favorite coach because, I mean, he was my position coach for 4 years, and he really showed me a lot about the game of football and just how to be better in life and not just in football.
Yeah, I have to say the same thing. Coach Jackson, I love working out, and since he's a strength and conditioning coach, we just connected more. And he's really good at motivating and trying to help me get better at the game, so.
Yeah. You'll get spits, not anything. I mean, especially like working with the linemen. I mean, and you'll get up in your face and in practice and games, and you'll really get the spit.
If you play football and you did not get some type of Coach Jackson fluid,
I think every coach has a unique characteristic that we like about them. But for me, I'd have to say it's Coach Langley. I mean, the guy shows up this year for the first time to teach me how to better myself as a quarterback, and he's got such a way of preparing me for games. It's ridiculously funny, and it's fun at the same time. Coach Langley is basically another father. He taught me right in the short time that we had, and I feel like I've known him forever. Definitely a person I'll definitely keep up with in my life, and with all his remarks and in various ways that shall not be discussed. But all in all, a great man, and all the coaches are great men in general. Coach Hughes is he's a good person, and I've enjoyed playing on his football team for 4 years.
I like all the coaches. I mean, I can't really choose a favorite. I got two, probably Coach Derek or Coach Long. Coach Derek, just because he's more, he's younger, so I could connect with him more, and we'd joke around. But Coach Long, just because freshman year, Coach Long was the freshman coach, and me and him connected real well, and he just talked to me about everything and basically just told me that just a lot of stuff, honestly. He just helped me with everything, helped me with plays, and he's still there for me, and I still joke with him all the time, so I probably won't ever forget him and what he's done for me.
Taking it out of the stuff, out of the vault. Killing this shit is my fault. I'ma be getting the car, getting back up on the fall. Fell on me out when I'm chasing a bar with all of my dogs, licking the dog. I'ma just punish you children. What? No, banish them off.
Police, fire, and emergency medical services will be unavailable until tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. when the purge concludes.
I'm in the mood to label us the leaders of the new school. This ain't for the radio, can't find this on YouTube. This the type of killing that these critics ain't used to. Victorious. 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 In this day and age, I got time for innovation. Time to be creative. Time too big to waste all my time on critics hating. Flattered by your opinions to show you out, just embracing. Now watch a worldly sunrise up. No daylight savings, go nuts when I have to. Glaze belt my sound in this beast on the house that we dreaming. Watch me way back up in the castle, my thoughts are distorted. Cause I recall guys were hating uncommonly. All of them became common denominators. Hold up. Try to overlook a rival. On me cause I got no competition. Now looking at an idol. You're doing long enough to pay for my attention. I was born to be glorious. It's definitely glorious. I'm destined to be glorious. To all I hate to display to remain glorious.
The crop.
Craft these chairs break. Well, this season, it was fun, of course, created a lot of memories, and we had some success here and there throughout the season, and I think this was one of the best teams that we've had for our wrestling program ever since it started, and I'm just really proud of everyone on the team and how far we've come as a family and as a group of individuals who can come together as a team and really do something for this school and put our name out there and put us on the map.
This season has definitely been really memorable. It's been more than just the success. Yeah, we did like stuff in state, but we'll normally go to state. But we've been a lot closer this year. Like all the wrestlers together. We went through a lot of hardships this year. We've lost like staff, and some of us lost family members, others have gone through other hardships, and we were all kind of just there to pick each other up. We're really good about this year. So it's more than just the wrestling. It's just been a really memorable year for the team, like being the brothers.
I mean, there's no way that you can spend like countless amounts of hours with someone and not be able to call them your family. I've grown relationships with people that I also didn't think I would. I really, depend on everyone on the team, and they depend on me, and that's what makes us a successful program.
Yeah, it's a love-hate relationship, and like, no matter what happens, we're all family.
I think in state, we could have pushed a little harder to come out with first place, but it's been a really good season to us. First time going to state and going to the finals.
As a team, I think we did really well this year. We made it to the state finals for the first time, which is a pretty big deal. Of course, we wanted to win state, but not everything can go our way. Overall, pretty good season.
Yeah, it was a good season. Second in the state, that was a big accomplishment. But also, like, in individuals, we had 11 that qualified for state. That was the most that we've ever had. And that was, like, something that meant a lot to us, and it was a good season.
As we started with a freshman, we weren't even region champs, and so it's really interesting and cool to see as this senior group has progressed, and now that we're seniors, I can look back and see like all the successes and all the drive that we've had to really further this program in the state of Tennessee and just in the sport of wrestling in general. And it's something that the senior group that we can carry with us. And I'm gonna miss the senior group. They're my family, they're my brothers, and I love them with all my heart, and I care for them, and if there's anything they need, then I'll always be here for them.
I think I'll miss that type of, that family that you build as you wrestle. Throughout my 4 years, I've seen ups and downs of almost everybody on the team, and just that brotherhood that we all share together, I think I'll miss that the most.
I'm gonna slouch. Don't let me slouch. I think the district semifinals this year, that was a really big game because we played Creekwood and we had lost in 5 sets both times, like when we played them during the regular season. But during the semifinals we won, it was like 18-16 or something. It was crazy, but yeah.
Yeah, I think the Creekwood was a really important game too. Just everybody kind of storming the court, I guess you could say, was the adrenaline rush after that. It was just, I know it's something I'm probably not going to be able to fill in college, so.
Yeah, definitely hanging out with the girls. I'm going to miss the time in the locker room where we just goof off and spend a lot of time with each other. Don't let one bad play get in your head. Just keep going. Be positive all the time, because that just helps incredibly, like a bunch.
Don't listen to anything that anybody says, especially Coach Ranson. Just don't. Love you, Coach Ranson.
I really liked whenever we went to Gatlinburg this year and we won the tournament.
I really like when one time we were playing a game and we had really, really bad reps. And so during halftime, Sizemore was like, okay, you guys just like don't react, don't laugh or anything, but I'm gonna like scream really loud about how bad they're reffing and then maybe they'll hear me. And so during halftime, he was just like yelling like, yeah, it's okay guys, I know these refs suck, but it's gonna be fine. Like, we just have to overcome it, and that was really funny.
Hannah Chris, our sophomore year, was playing, and she's kind of a timid player. She's not like one to like confront or even like really make contact at all. And one time she accidentally tripped a girl and she got a yellow card and she started crying. And she was running off the field like bawling, and everyone was just like, Hannah. So that was really fun. I really liked the teammates we had on our team. I think that especially this year, we had like all of a really good friendship and connection, and there wasn't really any drama or anything like we've had in the past. So it was just really fun. So I'm gonna miss like, I'm gonna miss just having like my friends and it just being fun.
I'm also really gonna miss the girls on the team. It was just a very encouraging environment, which we haven't really had in the past. Everyone was just really positive and nice to one another. So I'm gonna miss that.
I'm also gonna miss the encouraging environment and how everyone just always picked each other up. Even after a bad play or a bad game, we have this group chat. Everyone always texts encouraging things in it after Sizemore yells at us for 30 minutes after the game. So I'm gonna miss that. Well, I found like that it was easier to lead the team knowing that I'm older and most of the younger girls look up to me for help and guidance and what to do when they're in a certain situation.
Honestly, it wasn't that different. I just tried to make like every minute like memorable and like really take it in since it was the last year.
Sophia, come here for a sec.
What are you working on?
I took the state test final today.
Nice. Well, I'm really proud of you.
But then, you know, I just felt just right.
Will y'all excuse me? I need to take this.
Hello?
Yes.
Who is this? Who's calling?
Hey, Miss J-Ro, it's Brittany. Did Sophia stay home from school today?
No, she left for school early this morning. Is there a problem?
The ongoing story on Fallbrook High Sophia Jarrow is starting to take a turn as more time goes by with no conclusion.
Boys, listen, I get it, I really do. Your friend is missing, and we all want to be the one that finds her so we can be the hero.
She's ripped her vocal cords to the point of surgery. She's got bruises all around her neck from the attacker's hands. She's in bad shape.
You are ruining people's lives. Michael can't walk through the hallways at school without people bullying him, and Riley's being harassed more than she ever was before.
This is Sophia's case.
We could be looking for Sophia, and this may have helped us find her, and you guys want to withhold information.
Whoever did this is trying to cover it up.
I get it, Chandler, but everyone's upset. You can talk to me about it. You can talk to other people.
Of course there's hope in me that we'll find her. But imagine if we don't. Imagine if she's dead.
Hey guys, my name is Tanner Peterson. I'm the writer and director of Minus One, and we are so eager to tell you some of the biggest news that Minus One has ever had. we are an official selection of the Nashville Film Festival.
Yeah, there you go.
And to
show you guys, we came all the way out here to Nashville on top of a random parking garage just to tell you guys that we are probably one of the first high schools. I'd say we are.
There's no other high school in the Nashville Film Festival.
Nashville Film Festival, this is such a big deal. This is one of only 17 film festivals in the United States that is Academy Award qualifier. They get over 1,600 films submitted to them every year. They show about 250. There are over $100,000 of prizes that are decided by studio representatives, producers, and filmmakers. And a bunch of celebrities attend because this is an Academy Award qualifying festival. And minus one is an official selection of the Nashville Film Festival, and we are thrilled.
Now to the coronavirus emergency. There are now more than 2 million cases reported.
This was the deadliest tornado outbreak in the U.S.
To unleash the full power of the federal government in this effort today, I am officially declaring a national emergency.
Hello, Williamson County. This is Carol Birdsong calling.
We are now 3 weeks on from the death of George Floyd, and national demonstrations do not appear to be slowing down.
A retired Los Angeles Lakers basketball star Kobe Bryant has been killed in a helicopter crash. It happened this morning.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. You have arrived here in the middle of a global crisis, a racial pandemic, and worldwide expression of outrage.
The picture there, it burst into.
And you still made it.
And I am feeling so small. It was over my head. Nothing at all.
I want to thank you for leaving a lasting legacy on me and a lasting legacy on Fairview High School. Because in 20 years, students will be studying your class in their history books. And they're going to be noting how you stood strong in the face of a global pandemic. How you fought with resiliency and persistence to be here today. Know that it has truly been an honor for me to be your principal. I've enjoyed sitting with you during lunch and having those conversations about what's going on in your life at that moment in time and what's taking place at FHS that day. I enjoyed watching you perform on the athletic fields, on the courts, on the performing arts stage, or attending your band competitions. And I am proud to say that I am your principal. And I am proud to say that I will forever be the Yellow Jacket. I hope that through this extraordinary event, you were able to see how much each and every person in this room and each and every adult at FHS genuinely cares about you and loves you. Again, I am so proud of you. And as you enter the next phase of your life, remember these two things. Be the light in your community, and once a Yellow Jacket, always a Yellow Jacket. Congratulations.
I'm still learning to love, just starting to fall. Say something, I'm giving up on you.
All right, graduates, please stand. By the power vested in me by the Honorable Bill Lee, Governor of the great state of Tennessee, Dr. Penny Schwinn, Tennessee Commissioner of Education, Gary Anderson, Chairman, Williamson County Board of Education, and Jason Golden, Superintendent of Williamson County Schools, I confer the appropriate diplomas to the class of 2020. Jackets, you may turn your tassel.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
car, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. They was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping out the Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bags, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you with winning, put your lightest to the sky. How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with it, I just put it to the side. Bought a sense of baby, they could see it in my eyes. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
I was patient, yeah. Oh, I was patient, hey, oh. Now I can scream that we made it. Now everywhere I go, they say congratulations. Young graduation, yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Number old Ben Franklin. Cash. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Paso big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught up, get in the rows. Top flow lifestyle, top hunch on post. Malone, I got a play on my phone. You know what I'm on. Huncho Houdini is gone.